What are you going to do? Are you going to feed the llama?
Yes.
Yeah?
I was afraid last time, but Grandma gave me a stick.
But you're not afraid anymore.
No, because you have a stick. There you are.
Yay!
Yay!
Well, it's no doubt that times have been more than stressful during this COVID-19 experience, but that doesn't mean to say that there aren't still great things happening within our city. Take, for instance, where I am today, here at the High Park Zoo, visiting these cute guys. But I'm also here to welcome the new development that's going to house the capybaras and the llamas come next spring.
I am so proud to be here for our groundbreaking ceremony for the new llama and capybara building. To completely do this building with the drawings, with all the construction, it's about $700,000. It sounds like a lot of money, but if you think that the building we're going to build, because we're putting in a concrete base, a floor, the building we put up will probably last 100 years. This one, the logs are directly on the ground and therefore they are beginning to rot. So we are going to build a slightly bigger building. We're going out the back a bit, which makes more space for the llamas and more space for the capybaras. I would like to invite Mayor Tory to come and say a few words.
Parks and open space in the city have come to mean so much more to us during this period to keep us fit and keep us healthy, but I think also to keep us in a better state of mental well-being, given the confinement that everybody's experienced. And the new building is going to accommodate a greater educational purpose for kids and for families. And so I'm just proud to be here to say that the city is going to continue its support for this and that it's something that's going to be a real attraction for generations to come. Thank you very much.
I will now try to speak the native tongue of said llamas, see if they'll come to me.
Come hither, llamas. I have no food for you, but lots of love.
They're not having it.
We definitely need some space like this for when we come out of this on the other side.
And the kids love to come. It was one of the few places when we'd say, hey, let's go outside. They didn't complain when we suggested coming here.
Times have been financially tough on us all, but any donation you can help make towards the park, big or small, would be of great help. For more info on how you can do this, visit highparkzoo.ca.